A very warm welcome to all you amazing 7th graders to this class of English in which we will be studying the chapter called Bringing Up Carrie by Dhanu Gopal Mukherjee from your book An Alien Hand. But before we begin, let's understand what is new at An Academy. You can get a flat 10% discount on the Plus subscription if you use my code, which is SWS10. So An Academy is the number one way to come number one in your schools and to ace your school exams. So why don't we go for the Plus subscription today? Use my code SWS10 and get the 10% off. Also, welcome to my class. My name is Sweksha Sahai and I am your English educator. I'm also an English and IELTS trainer and I have training experience for almost 5 years. And apart from English, I know languages like French and Spanish. Here are some awesome words which I made a note of from your chapter. Let's look at them. So the words to remember from this chapter are pavilion, which means a large open structure or tent which provides shelter. Ebony is a dense black or brown hardwood tree. Luscious means shiny. Hatchet means a small axe with a short handle to use with one hand. And mutilated is a word which is mentioned in your chapter, which means disfigured due to injury. Also, ponderous is an amazing word to use, which means thoughtful. Astonishment to great surprise. So these were some words which I thought that you should make a note of to enrich your vocabulary and to make your spoken and written English much better. You can use these words in sentences and that way you can add these words to your vocabulary very easily. So whenever you have time, do try to make some sentences with these words. Moving on. So I'll give you a little background about this chapter. Carrie is a 5-month-old baby elephant who lives and grows up with a 9-year-old friend and keeper. Carrie doesn't eat much, just about 16 kilograms of delicious twigs a day. Playful and sensitive, Carrie saves a boy from drowning. So this is the background of the story. Like whatever happens in the story, Carrie jo hai wo ek elephant hai aur jo hamare lekhak hain, jo writer hain, wo ek 9-year-old bachcha hai, okay, who is also Carrie's friend and his keeper, okay. And the major incident that takes place, there are two major incidents which take place in this chapter. One is that Carrie saves a boy from drowning and the other one is that our author finds Carrie stealing bananas from his house, and we will see what happens when those two incidents take place. So in this class we will be doing a summary and the question answers, and I have also I have already given you the difficult words from this chapter. So let's begin with the summary now. Carrie was an elephant. He was 5 months old when he came to the author. Carrie lived in a pavilion. It was under a thatched roof which rested on thick tree stumps. Carrie bumped against the poles as he moved about the enclosure. So you must get a picture now ki Carrie kaun hai aur ye cheeze kya ho rahi hai. So Carrie ek elephant hai aur wo kitna mahine ka hai? Wo 5 mahine ka hai. Okay? 5 mahine ka tha jab wo author ke paas aaya tha. Aur Carrie ek pavilion mein rehta hai. Pavilion ka matlab maine aapko abhi bataya. It means a shelter. And it is made of a thatched roof. अब थैच का मतलब क्या होता है? थैच मतलब वो जो गांव के घरों पे आप रूफ देखते हैं ना, जो कि कच्चे होते हैं, थोड़ा सा उस पर घास सा होता है, फिर उसके ऊपर एक मिट्टी के छोटे छोटे ईंट से होते हैं, पतले पतले से. सो दैट इज़ कॉल्ड अ थैच रूफ, जो कि थोड़े स्लांटिंग से होते हैं, जो हट्स के ऊपर बने होते हैं. सो दैट इज़ अ थैच रूफ, ओके. और जो उसका पवेलियन था वो स्टम्प्स के ऊपर, यानी स्टम्प्स यानी मोटी मोटी लकड़ियों के जो क्लब्स थे वो अंदर डले हुए थे, काफ़ी अंदर ज़मीन तक, ताकि कैरी अगर उसे हिलाए भी तो वो गिरे ना. सो दोज वर मेड ऑफ ट्री स्टम्प्स, यानी जो ट्री ट्री पेड़ को काट करके जो उसके नीचे का हिस्सा बचता है ना, तना, उसको बहुत अंदर तक डाला हुआ था. एंड दोज वर ट्री स्टम्प्स. नाउ यू मस्ट अंडरस्टैंड दैट इज हाउ द एनक्लोजर फॉर कैरी वॉज. Yet the poles didn't give way. It was so because these poles were made of thick tree stumps. Carey enjoyed his morning bath in the river. He would lie in the water for a long time. On coming out, he would squeal with pleasure. After the bath, the author would leave him on the edge of the jungle. तो कैरी जो था वो अपना जो डेली शावर था वो बहुत ही इंजॉय करता था एंड ही यूज टू गो टू द रिवर एवरी डे. इमेजिन द लग्जरी ऑफ गोइंग टू अ रिवर फॉर अ शावर एवरी डे. ऑफकोर्स ही वुड इंजॉय इट. सो ही यूज टू इंजॉय एंड ही वुड स्क्वील विद प्लेजर. नाउ स्क्वीलिंग एक ऐसी आवाज़ है जो एनिमल्स निकालते हैं वेन एवर दे आर हैप्पी और समटाइम्स इवन इन पेन. ओके, कभी कभी आपने पिग्स को सुना होगा ये स्क्वील करने की आवाज़ निकालते हुए. ओके, और अगर नहीं सुना है यू कैन ऑलवेज गो ऑन यूट्यूब एंड वॉच एनिमल्स स्क्वीलिंग. ओके, एंड देन यू कैन गेट एन आइडिया ऑफ वॉट अ स्क्वील साउंड्स लाइक. ओके, आफ्टर अ बाथ द ऑथर वुड लीव हिम ऑन द एज ऑफ द जंगल. ही वुड गो हिमसेल्फ इन टू द फॉरेस्ट टू गेट सम ट्विग्स फॉर द एलिफेंट्स डिनर. इट टुक अ लॉन्ग टाइम. फर्स्ट द ऑथर वुड शार्पन हिज हैचेट विच टुक हाफ एन आवर. और हैचेट का मतलब हमने पढ़ा है अभी थोड़ी देर पहले. इट्स अ स्मॉल एक्स लाइक टूल विच इज यूज्ड फॉर यू नो कटिंग ट्विग्स. देन द ऑथर हैड टू क्लाइंब ट्रीज टू गेट द मोस्ट डेलिकेट एंड टेंडर ट्विग्स. डूइंग ऑल दिस नेचुरली टुक अ लॉन्ग टाइम. कैरी एंड द ऑथर व गुड friends. Now if there is one thing that we have to understand from this chapter is the friendship of Carey and the author. Okay, but Carey once pushed him into the stream. It was to save the life of a boy. He was a boy lying on the bottom of the river. He dived and pulled the body of the drowning boy to the surface. However, the author was not a swimmer, so he could not come ashore. The current began to drag him down. Carey saw it and he came fast into the water. The author caught his trunk and he pulled both the author and the boy ashore. तो एक बार एक बच्चा पानी में डूब रहा था तो कैरी ने ऑथर को बुलाया और उन्होंने because author was not very strong as a swimmer and you have to understand that the author himself was a 9-year-old boy, because of which he could not pull another boy out. He did not have the strength. So what did Carey do in this situation? He was of course a very kind-hearted animal. So what he did was, with the help of his trunk, he pulled both author and the other boy who was drowning. This was one story. Carey was like a baby. And like a baby, he had to be told when he was naughty. He developed a taste for bananas and he began to steal these bananas. Chapter में आपने पढ़ा ही होगा कि कैरी है, उसको एक बार किसी ने बनाना दिया और उसने फिर बनाना खाने की आदत लगा ली. And then, because he liked bananas, he started stealing them from the house of the author. So large plates of fruits were kept on a table in the dining room. Carey would put his trunk through the window to the bananas. In one attempt, he would take them all. Now you can understand the trunk of an elephant is very large. So what Carey could do was, he would just take all of it in one go. He would then quietly go to his pavilion and there he ate the bananas at peace without being seen. So basically he was being a real thief. At last, the author caught him stealing. तो फाइनली क्या होता है कि हमारा जो ऑथर है, इन द बुक वी कैन सी दैट ऑथर को बहुत डांट पड़ती है. उनके पेरेंट्स को लगता है कि द ऑथर इज स्टीलिंग. पहले लगता है कि द सर्वेंट्स आर स्टीलिंग, देन दे फेल्ट लाइक द ऑथर इज स्टीलिंग. एंड बिकॉज ऑफ विच द ऑथर गॉट रियली एंग्री ऑन कैरी, क्योंकि कैरी की वजह से उनको डांट पड़ गई. सो वेन ही वॉज स्कोल्डेड, सो कैरी वॉज गेटिंग स्कोल्डेड बाय द author. And when he was scolded, he understood like a baby and did not squeal again. Again, like babies, he was a quick learner. So Carey learnt Mali after 3 lessons, but it took him 3 weeks to learn Dhat. Dhat was the command to sit, while Mali was the command to walk. These commands were taught to him just as one teaches a child. In the book, of course, it is given in much more detail how this was taught by the author. The teaching of master call to an elephant is a difficult thing. An elephant generally takes 5 years to learn it. It is the most important signal for an elephant to learn. It is so because it helps an elephant to save his master's life. Sometimes they are lost in the jungle and there is no way out. So basically a master call is a mixture of a hiss of a snake and the growl of a lion is what we studied in the book. Okay. और ये जो कॉल होती है ये सिखाई जाती है एलिफेंट्स को टू सेव देयर मास्टर्स. वेन एवर द मास्टर मेक्स दिस कॉल इट्स वन ऑफ द वेरी डेंजरस एंड रिस्की कॉल्स एंड शुड बी मेड ओनली वेन देर इज ह्यूज अमाउंट ऑफ डेंजर. ओके, बिकॉज द एलिफेंट स्टार्ट्स टू अपरूट ट्रीज. वो ट्रीज को उखाड़ के फेंक देता है और फिर क्या होता है कि जितने भी एनिमल्स हैं वो आपके रास्ते से हट जाते हैं एंड दैट मेक्स अ सेफ वे for you to go home. Then the master makes a strange hissing and howling sound, as I told you, in the elephant's ear. A trained elephant understands it and at once pulls out a tree in front of him. This frightens all the animals away. Even the tiger is frightened. The elephant goes on pulling down trees one after the other. Thus, a path is made out of the forest. So that was your chapter in a nutshell, or that was a summary of your chapter. So I have given out the summary, I have also given out the difficult words, and now we are going to do the question answers of this chapter. So the enclosure in which Carrie lived had a thatched roof that lay on thick tree stumps. Examine the illustrations of Carrie's pavilion and say why it was built that way. So you'll have to go back to the book and you have to see how the pavilion was made and why was it made that way. The answer to this question is, Carrie was a large clumsy elephant and walked about hitting poles. The enclosure was built on stumps to provide strong fire foundation so that it could withstand the pressure of Carrie's weight and doesn't collapse. So, uska answer ye hai ki jo Carrie tha wo kafi hill dul ke chala karta tha. The way the elephant walks like that, okay? और उससे क्या होता था कि जो उनके साइड के वॉल्स थे और जो साइड के पोल्स थे वो उससे टकराया करते थे. सो टू गिव दैट पोल अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ स्ट्रेंथ वहाँ पे ट्री के स्टम्प्स लगा दिए गए थे. ओके, ताकि जो एनक्लोजर है वो कोलैप्स ना हो. दैट इज योर आंसर. डिड कैरी इंजॉय हिज मॉर्निंग बाथ इन द रिवर? गिव अ रीजन टू सपोर्ट योर आंसर. So yes, Carrie enjoyed his bath a lot because he would squeal with pleasure when the author rubbed his back with water. So we have seen in the chapter and we have also seen in the summary that Carrie used to enjoy his bath in the river a lot and it was the most joyful time of his day. Finding good twigs for Carrie took a long time. Now why is that? So we have seen in the chapter that Carrie was not one of those elephants who would eat any twigs. Okay, the twigs had to be of a perfect shape. So Carrie liked fresh, luscious twigs and it required a very sharp hatchet to get them. If the twigs were not right, were not in the right shape, Carrie would not even touch them. Okay, and that is why the author had to really choose the twigs and cut them properly, which took a long time. That is your answer. The next question from the book is, why did Carrie push his friend into the stream? So, ये भी शायद आपने पढ़ा होगा, अभी हमने दोहराया भी उसको, कि to save the life of a drowning boy. The answer is, Carrie pushed the author into the stream because he wanted to show the author the boy who was drowning in the river. Carrie wanted the author to save the life of the kid. And that was the reason why Carrie threw his friend, meaning the author, in the river. The next question is, Carrie was like a baby. What were the main points of comparison? ये ऐसा क्यों कहा गया है कि Carrie was like a baby? So Carrie had to be trained like we train babies. Once Carrie got into the habit of stealing bananas from the dining table. When the author found out, he scolded Carrie, and from that time, Carrie never stole bananas again. But just like how kids learn very quickly, Carrie also learned that he should not steal, and in fact, if anyone gave him any fruits after this incident, he would squeal as if to thank them. The next question is, Carrie helped himself with all the banana in the house. How did he do that? Okay, so Carrie had realized that the bananas were always placed on the dining table. So he started stealing them with the help of his long trunk. What he used to do, I'm sure you guys remember, that he would put his trunk through the window and he would steal all the bananas. The next part of the answer is just that. So he would hide behind the open window and directly steal the bananas from the dining table with the help of his trunk. Carrie learned the commands to sit and to walk. What were the instructions for each command? Very important question. So the instruction to sit was Dhat and the instruction to walk was Mali. Carrie learned to walk in 3 lessons, but he took 3 weeks to learn to sit. And the next question is, what is the master call and why is it the most important signal for an elephant to learn? This also is a very important question. It's a long answer, but it's better to remember this. A master call is a strange hissing and howling sound that the trainer teaches the elephant. It takes 5 years for an elephant to learn it. You also have to remember this number. It takes 5 years for an elephant to remember and to learn this. Okay, it is used when you are lost in a jungle. Once the elephant hears this call, he starts uprooting trees to scare away animals and makes way so that one can reach home safely. So this is a call to save the master. And that brings us to the end of this revision and this discussion of the chapter Bringing Up Carrie. Okay, now let's understand the features of the Plus subscription at Unacademy. You can learn from the life from the comfort of your home, and that too in live classes. Unlimited access to all the courses that we have at Unacademy if you take the Plus subscription. Also, top educators of India on one platform. So you find all the top educators of India teaching you on the same platform, and isn't that amazing? Regular doubt clearing sessions, exhaustive coverage of syllabus, mentorship and guidance. Also, you get PDF of all your study material. There are practice tests, live test series and batch courses. The Unacademy subscription pricing is now on your screen, and you can use my code SWS10 to get a 10% flat discount on all of these subscriptions. The Unacademy iconic subscription features are a personal mentorship. I think that is the first and the most amazing feature of the iconic subscription, that you get personal mentorship. Okay, there are live doubt solving sessions, which means you can ask your questions and get an answer in the live class. Okay, there's a weekly report that gets generated to check all your improvement that you have made during the week. Your parents can also connect with us and understand your improvement and how well you have done in the past week. There's a study planner to plan the course for you and to help you cope up with the entire course. And all the benefits of Unacademy Plus subscription. तो जितने हमने प्लस में देखे थे वो तो हैं ही, और साथ में ये सारे भी हैं. The iconic prices are right now on your screen and you can go for it with my code SWS10 and get a 10% flat discount. So Unacademy, let's crack it. Please do like, share and subscribe to this channel. To get all the updates from us, you can also click the bell icon to get all your updates. Do not miss anything from this channel, because we are the only one giving you the most quality education in India. Unacademy is the number one way to come number one at school. So be with us, keep learning with us, and I'll see you in the next class. Thank you so much.